Hey guys, it's me, Sandy, and as always, don't forget to follow me on my social media at SandyBaby16, as well as subscribing for more updates by clicking the little red button on the side. So today I'm going to be reviewing the KL Polish, and I'm so excited because I've been waiting so long, and I ordered this a long time ago, and I'm just now getting to it. So sorry about that. So first, we're going to talk about the brush. Yes, everyone and their mothers is talking about this brush and how it's like a short little square stubby brush, but I honestly like it. It is hard to work with at first, and you'll see why in the video. So the first color that I'm going to be talking about from her collection is Snickerdoodle, and I love this color. It's not one of my favorites from her collection, but I feel like it's the most professional looking one, the more natural one if you're going for that kind of look, or if you work at a hospital, or if you work at an office where they don't allow you to wear like bright color nail polish. This would be perfect because it basically like blends into your skin and it just looks, you know, like a nude, like professional color. And as you can see by the brush, I have thicker nail beds, so it is easier to work with. But if you have thinner nail beds or like smaller nail beds, then it might be harder to work with. So yes, and I'm not a professional nail guru in any way, so I'm sorry if my swatches are a little rough and not professional looking or perfect. So this is a second coat. All of these colors require a second coat, at least in my opinion. You could get away with only doing a first coat, but if you don't want to have any streaks or any discoloration, then I suggest that you do a second coat, and it just looks better and darker. The color will show more, and this is Snickerdoodle. So the next color I'm going to be talking about is Broccoli and Chocolate, and this is actually my least favorite from the collection. And it's not because I don't like the color, I think the color is actually really unique. It is because of the formula, and as you can see in this clip, it is very sheer and you need at least three coats to build it up to get to the color that you actually want, the color that is actually shown on the bottle. So this is what the first coat looks like, and not good, not good. And now I'm putting on the second coat, and I am going to be putting on a third coat because this color still made it look streaky, and you will see how much better it looks with the third coat. And this is the third coat, and just look at that pinky. And look at those nails, girl, but just don't look at my ugly swatch, because yeah, this one did not come out how I wanted it to come out. Alright, so now for one of my favorite colors is Caramello. Yes, so this reminds me of the little candy that you get, the little caramel candy squares. It basically dries up that color, and it looks mustard, but it actually dries up darker than this, and it just looks like it in this lighting. But honestly, I really like this color, and I actually got to try this color, and it basically lasted like more than a week, and I didn't even put a top coat or a base coat on my nail. And that's what I love about these colors, is that they last a really, really long time, and you don't really have to put like a base coat or a top coat, because honestly, who has time to do that? I know I don't, girl. I'm lucky enough if I even do my nails. So I am now going to be putting on a second coat, because for the sake of them lasting longer and looking better, I'm going to be doing this. And that, my friends, is Caramello. So the next color is called Brick Sidewalk. And I really, really love the color. So I actually did my nails, and I got compliments on this like within the first second of even going out. I got compliments at work, I got compliments from my friends, and this is just such a beautiful color, and I also love the formula on this. So you will need a second coat when using this color, as you can see that I am applying it there. And one of the things that I forgot to mention was that it does transfer on paper. I work in an office, so I do a lot of filing and I do a lot of scanning, and I just work with paper, and I left some red marks on a piece of paper because I was like going through them. Oops, yeah. Other than that, I think this color is so pretty and it's definitely one of my favorite in her collections. I totally recommend buying this color if you haven't already done so. So the last color I saved the best for last is called Zoey, and it is a pretty mauve pale peach lavender color. And this formula is probably the best one in her collection because I'm a beginner and I absolutely love how I did my nails. They came out perfect and there wasn't any like bulkiness to my nails. There wasn't any like sheer spots or streaks that I left, and it is probably one of my best swatch video, or maybe I just got better as the time went by. But you also do need a second coat because this is the first coat and it is thin. It is like a little thin layer, but the second coat gives it more definition, more color, and just makes the color pop. So this is Zoey with two coats on. And I'm so sorry that I don't have gumption. I actually regret not buying it because I think it would probably be an awesome color, but at the time I didn't think I was gonna like it. So sorry about that. I'm gonna pick up her new one actually that came out too, and I'm so excited for that launch. So I hope you guys enjoyed my swatches of Zoey and Caramello, Broccoli on Chocolate, Brick Sidewalk, and Snickerdoodle. And please subscribe again if you haven't already done so, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!